गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ सेट्स वी शैल स्टार्ट न्यू टॉपिक ट्रिगोनोमेट्री। ट्रिगोनोमेट्री इज नॉट ए न्यू टर्म फॉर यू बिकॉज यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड इन स्टैंडर्ड 10। सो जस्ट लेट अस रिकैपिटुलेट स्टैंडर्ड 10। ट्रिगोनोमेट्री इज बेसिकली डिफाइंड फॉर राइट एंगल ट्रायंगल वेयर एंगल मेजर्ड बिटवीन बेस एंड हाइपोटेनियस। दिस साइड मींस परपेंडिकुलर साइड और एल्टीट्यूड इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय पी, यू नो इट। दिस इज बेस एंड लॉन्गेस्ट साइड इज कॉल्ड हाइपोटेनियस। एंड यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट टी रेशियोज in standard 11. So what are t ratios? Sine theta is equals to p upon h, cos theta is equals to b upon h, and tan theta is equals to p upon b. P stand for perpendicular, B for base, and they are reciprocals. Reciprocal of tan theta is cot theta, which is B upon P. Cos theta reciprocal is sec theta, that is H upon B, and reciprocal of sin theta is cosec theta, that is represented by H upon P. These are the T ratios you already studied. Beside this, you have learnt about trigonometrical tables. See how we write the table. First, write down the normal angle is started from 0. 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. Then make the table for sine theta. In very first step, number it by whole number, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Divide each of them by 4. And take the square root of this term. So 0 upon 4 is 0 and square root is 0. This will be value of sine 0 degree. Similarly, square root of 1 upon 4 is 1 by 2. This is value of sine 30 degree. This becomes 1 by root 2. A square root of 3 by 4 is root 3 by 2, and a square root of 1 is 1, 4 by 4 is 1. Next, make table of cos theta. Write this value in decreasing order, like sine 90 degrees 1, cos 0 degrees 1, then root 3 by 2, then 1 by root 2, then 1 by 2 and 0. Divide corresponding term. Tan theta means tan 0 degree 0 by 1, that is 0. Divide correspondingly, 2 and 2 should cancel. It becomes 1 by root 3. Similarly, on division it is 1. Root 3, 1 upon 0, that means undefined term. Now take the reciprocal of tan, you will get value of cot. Reciprocal of cos will get sec. Reciprocal of sine, you will get cosec. So these are the tables you have already studied. Now here in standard 11, trigonometry is simply meaning trigonometron. When we make its etymology, then it comes three letters, tri, गोनोमेट्रॉन. सो मेजरमेंट ऑफ थ्री एंगल्स इन अ ट्रायंगल इज कॉल्ड ट्रिगोनोमेट्री. सो दिस इज ब्रांच ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स विच डील्स अबाउट the angles of a triangle and its properties See the children, you are studying plane trigonometry, means triangle formed by sides. Now suppose this is a circle and we take three arcs of a circle, 1, 2, and 3, and if we form triangle by these arcs, then this will be like this one. We study in another part, that is called, such type of triangle is called spherical triangle, and its study is called spherical trigonometry. But you have to study only plane trigonometry here. This is not in your portion. Now let us consider this circle. Suppose O be the center of the circle. OA and OB be two arcs such that OA, OB be two radii such that OA is equal to OB, it is obvious, and AB, these all are the same measurement, same length. Then the angle represented at center theta is called radian. One radian. So radian is the angle. Where it is formed at center. So radian is the angle subtended at center of a circle, by an arc whose length is equal to radius of the circle, right? Now see one important formula. Prove that in a circle of radius r, if an arc of length L subtends an angle theta at the center, at the center, then theta is equals to L pi r. Obviously, this is a theorem, but it must be used as a formula also. You require its proof, and later we will use in while solving problems in different parts of trigonometry. Now see its proof. Consider a circle with center O. Let OA and OB be its two radii such that angle AOB is equals to theta radian. Radian is represented by C in this way, by C, and arc AB is equals to L. Arc AB is equals to L. Now mark a point C on arc AB such that AC is equals to R. AC means arc AC is equals to R, that is radius of the circle. Joined OC calculate angle AOC. Obviously length of arc is equal to radius, so according to definition of radian, this is equals to 1 radian because length is equals to length of arc is equals to radius of the circle. Now in I think standard 8 or 9 you have studied that angle AOB, angle AOB by angle AOC, this ratio is equals to length of arc AB upon length of arc AC. Use this property here. Angle AOB is theta, angle AOC is 1 radian, arc AB is equals to L and arc AC is equals to R. Therefore, theta is equals to L upon R. You may write here, angles at the center, this ratio is called angles at the center of a circle, angles at the center of a circle are proportional to length of R. Proportional to corresponding length of arc. By using this property, we will get this ratio, and by this ratio, this is proved of one formula. Children, when you have studied about types of angle, then one type is complete angle. You know what is a complete angle? The angle measures 360 degree is called complete angle. So complete circle, in a circle the complete angle at the center is either 360 degrees or 2 pi radian. You already know it. Means 2 pi radian is equals to 360 degree. So pi radian is equals to 180 degree. This is relation between radian and degree. As we know, pi radian is 180 degree. So 1 radian is equals to 180 by pi degree. The value of pi is 22/7. So 180 upon 22, and this 7 becomes in numerator. Cancel it by 2. So 90 × 7/11 or 630/11. So 1 radian, therefore 1 radian is approximately equal to 57 degree 16 minutes and 21 second approximately. 1 radian is equals to 57 degree 16 minute 21 second approximately. Similarly 180 degree is equals to pi radian. So 180 degree means 1 degree is equals to pi by 180 radian or 22/7 into 180 radian. So this is approximately equals to 0.0174 degree. Sorry, radian. This is an approximate value. Already 60 degree is pi by 3, 45 degree is pi by 4. Now you are in position to calculate. Now see an example. Convert 15 degree into radians. Convert 15 degree into radians. So you will solve like this. Since 180 degree is equals to pi radian, so 15 degree will be pi by 180 into 15 radian. Cancel 15, 1 and 2. So pi by 12 radian. 15 degree is equals to pi by 12 radian. Now if you have to convert radian into degree, like next question, convert 7 pi by 12 radian. 12 radian into degrees. into degrees, then 7 pi by 12 should be written as 7 into pi is 180 degree by 12. Now this value is in degree. Simplify this one. 15, it should be 105 degree. But in question like this, convert 3 by 4 radian, 3 by 4 radian into degrees, into degrees. So since 1 radian is equals to 100 by pi degree, 3 by 4 radian is equals to 180 by pi into 3 by 4 degree. Write down the value of pi here, that should be 22 by 7. So this should be written as 180 upon 22 into 7 into 3 into divided by 4. Now cancel it, that is 45. Simplify and get result. So this should be approximately 42.8 or 9 degree. So therefore 3 by 4 radian is 42.8 degree approximately. This will be your result. This will be your result. So children, in this way we convert degrees into radian or radian into degrees. In my next class we will solve some more problems from very first exercise of trigonometry. In my next class, today you have done the basics of the trigonometry. You must remember the formulas, first of all tables between 0 to 90 degree, and then we start the problems. You must learn the proof of theta is equals to L by R. Then we proceed to the next exercise.